Why would you want to do that to your business? Why would you want somebody like your head chef that cooks, that feeds a bunch of people, to go on Hell's Kitchen and get reamed by Chef Ramsay? Like,
where'd the beat go? Oh, ain't that something? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming.
Hands on my head, can't tell me nothing. Got a taste of the fame, it'll pump my stomach. You familiar with Chef Ramsay, Gordon Ramsay?
You mean chef?
Chef.
Head chef.
Head chef, Mr. Chef, whatever you want to call him. Oh my God, that guy.
Lord Supreme.
I love watching him, because I first saw him in Hell's Kitchen. I'm like, man, this guy's an asshole. But then when you watch him with kids, and then when you watch him and you get in. Oh,
yeah, MasterChef
kids. The only reason why he's like that to the adults in Hell's Kitchen is because they're adults. They can take it. They need to know what it's like under pressure.
It's not and even that, actually. It's the Hell's Kitchen people are actual kitchen, like cook mm-hmm. professionals. They're supposed to know what they're
doing. Yeah. And that's why I love watching him, though, because you see the softer side of him and this and that. He really knows his shit. Definitely. I loved watching Kitchen Nightmares, and he's not really like he is on Hell's Kitchen, but then he comes into Kitchen Nightmares and he's with you and he's patient with you at first, but then he tells you how it needs to be. And if you get up into his face, he's going to get up into yours, and he's one of the most badass British guys.
Don't make him tell you twice.
Yeah. If I was captured, I'd have him and Jason Statham come and save me. Jason Statham to actually rescue me, and Chef Gordon Ramsay to actually have a plate of food there, because I'd probably not have eaten for a while.
He'd also probably be able to like humiliate some of the guards.
Yeah, exactly.
Like,
exactly.
Yo, piece of shit.
Exactly. So anyway, speaking of Hell's Kitchen, the reason why we're talking about this is because Hell's Kitchen is in its 20th season, and a St. Louis chef, is going to be featured on Hell's Kitchen. Trent Garvey, also known as Chef Gravy, and we got a picture of him right here. He is the executive chef of the Blue Duck in Maplewood. So he is on the left right there. Obviously, the one on the right is Chef Gordon Ramsay. I love that picture of him, too. That's just mm-hmm. It captures his whole personality on Hell's Kitchen. But yeah, this season is going to be called Young Guns. And the reason why it's being called Young Guns is because they are having chefs from all across America that are around 23 years old, and they're already chefs. The cool thing is I believe that Chef Gravy on the left at the Blue Duck in Maplewood, he's the executive chef. He's been the executive chef there for 3 years. The guy's only 23. And this is a picture of the Blue Duck in Maplewood. I love their food there. I've only been there a couple times, but they have great food. Can you imagine that, though, Booster? 23 and he's already an executive chef. I mean, that means that he is working his ass off.
Definitely.
I was clowning around at 23. I didn't know what the hell I wanted to do at 23. And this guy's an executive chef. So I wish him the best on the show.
I don't know. You know, man,
you like to cook. What would you think?
I really like to cook, but I'll be honest with you, like, that would be intimidating to me.
Yeah.
I've never been in a professional kitchen. I've never gone to any kind of culinary school. So that kind of environment is kind of foreign to me.
Right.
Where it's like, I mean, a lot of those people, they get separated into specialists.
Yeah.
So it's not like you're constantly doing everything.
You got one person doing fish,
their only job is just to. So the head chef and the sous chef are typically the only people, and like most of them are just like checking and making sure that what the other chefs are doing is right. But there's the guy who's like in charge of the grill. So it's like you do the same thing for like 6, 7,
yeah.
8, 10, 12, 13 hours at a time. And so you better know what you're doing. Because we were just talking about how like MasterChef, he's a little bit easier.
He's a little bit, yeah.
Because they're home cooks. They've never been
Chef Ramsay,
there.
Man. But anyway, this guy from Maplewood, the Blue Duck, he's the executive chef, 23 years old, and he's going to go there. Now, this is one sure. thing. I posted this. I wrote an article on this. You guys can check it out on undergroundstl.com. But he's going to be going on the show. You know he's going to get butchered. Everybody does. They get butchered by Chef Ramsay on that show. I never really hear within the first, like, you know, few episodes of Hell's Kitchen,
they whittle it down to one person.
Yeah.
So
it's like, I mean, everybody at one point is going to get berated. And when I posted this, I had some people commenting, like, why would you want to do that to your business? Why would you want somebody like your head chef that cooks, that feeds a bunch of people, to go on Hell's Kitchen and get reamed by Chef Ramsay? Like, couldn't that hurt your business? And then I stopped and I thought about it. I'm like, guy's a professional. He knows what he's doing, or should know what he's doing. But then also, anybody that's going on Hell's Kitchen, anybody that's going on there, it's publicity. They're getting attention. For sure. And you got to be on Hell's Kitchen with Chef Ramsay. And that is a stressful environment, Hell's Kitchen. I mean, they literally only had the dinner service, I think, from one time to another. At least that's how it looks on the show. And, I think it's good for him. I think it's going to be good. I just hope he doesn't get eliminated. Like
Trial
the first
hell.
One to get eliminated.
But yeah,
if you've eaten
that.
At the Blue Duck, though, if you've eaten at the Blue Duck, he does a pretty damn good job.
I'll have to check it out.
Damn. It's a lot of, it's just good. You guys got to go on there and look it up. Like, there's so many good items.
Is it Southern cuisine?
It's a lot of barbecue type. Okay, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, but,
Southern Midwest.
All that kind of stuff. Yeah. It's basically comfort food. How they describe it on Facebook is comfort food with a twist. Yeah, that's comfort food with a twist. And they have a lot of craft beer on tap there, cans there. All that kind of stuff. They make like cocktails and So I've been there twice, once to eat, second time to drink. So yeah, guys, check this season out, Hell's Kitchen, season 20. The cool thing is they're not just picking any chefs. Obviously, like we said, they're picking guys that are 23 years old. But these are guys that really couldn't afford $100,000 for culinary school. These are guys that actually grew up learning how to cook from YouTube videos, you know, and going back and forth. And
same way I did.
Yeah, exactly. And so this is like these are the underdogs that are getting a shot at this season. Mm-hmm. And definitely get on there. Definitely support them and head on down to the Blue Duck in Maplewood, because it's a fun time. I like the Blue Duck. You don't get this on any of the mainstream media about St. Louis. You don't get this on KSDK,
what?
KMOV, Fox 2,
who?
KPLR 11.
No way.
You don't get this on 105.7 The Point,
okay.
KSHE 95, 92.3 WIL, whatever the hell. Okay, you don't get it there. You get it. You get it right here at Underground St. Louis, where we go deep.